Hey, how's it going? This is Pikachu. In this video, we're going to talk about Bitcoin price prediction. After doing some research and looking at the charts and the patterns and kind of seeing how the world is evolving, right? And how the blockchain technology is taking over and how much of the market cap actually Bitcoin and cryptocurrency is holding. It's actually very interesting in where Bitcoin can be just a year, maybe even 5 years from now. So without that, let's go ahead and dive into it. But before we do, hit that subscribe button so you never miss another video again. We'd like to talk about the different ways how people can stack up on wealth assets, protect themselves against inflation, government corruption, and actually start building real wealth and they can pass on to generations to come. The average person right now, it's never been easier to start building real wealth and eliminate liabilities and build up more assets that appreciate in value and duplicate. Listen, I'm not a financial advisor, but I like to share with people the best practices and ideas I think that will allow you to start building up wealth in our digital age right now. With that said, let's go ahead and dive into it. First, let's look at a fear and greed index about Bitcoin, which really just kind of bags the whole cryptocurrency market when it comes to the fear and greed index. So right now, right, fear means basically people are afraid, you know, the average people, I should say, are afraid to invest in cryptocurrency because perhaps of a big drop that it just recently did. Now, greed is when people are buying cryptocurrency like crazy, right? So about a month ago, when everything was green and going up in crazy percentages, the average person was buying it up, right? And then right now we're at that extreme fear level still. So people are afraid. They don't know what's going on. While the big whales are stacking up on Bitcoin right now because they did an organized sell-off, which worked out nicely, took a big dip. But right now when we go to fiatleague.com, we see in real time how much cryptos are being bought up. As you can see, Bitcoin is surging nicely. People are investing into it. We see a big surge of Ethereum being bought up right now and some other cryptos, right, that we won't get too much into right now. But this is a live, you know, feed that shows you how much cryptos are being bought consistently. As you can see in just a few seconds we've been here, a lot is being grabbed just because the big whales, you know, when they sell off high and it takes a big drop, they just buy a lot more Bitcoin low. So that's kind of what's going on, understanding that the big investors are buying it back right now. So it might be a good idea to invest. Now, here's a prediction that I think can happen. Bitcoin right now, 35,000, almost 36,000. But here's the thing, it went up all the way up to what, almost 65,000 at one point. And this was just April. So about last month up to May, Bitcoin being at an all-time high over 60,000, after they did a nice organized sell-off, you know, it dropped all the way to 30, about 50% of its value. And now what they're doing, the big investors, they're buying it back. Now Bitcoin can still make another dip down, maybe even as low as 25,000 or so. Nobody knows, but even if it does, it's just a matter of time before it bounces back up to all-time highs. But here's the way I look at it. Let's say that Bitcoin has the potential to go to $1 million or even beyond. Because some articles, you know, we even had guys like John McAfee, who in 2017 predicted Bitcoin would go over $1 million. And that was considered like crazy speculation. It might not even seem as that crazy. Because by 2025, something called the Bitcoin halving occurs. And when that happens, Bitcoin makes some big moves. It means that it's a lot harder, more expensive to mine Bitcoin, and it has to go up in value. So potentially it can reach up to $1 million. Now, when you listen to a guy like Robert Kawasaki, who really is just all about investing in real estate and silver and gold, just about a year ago, he had no faith in Bitcoin. He said it might not even survive. It's too new. We don't know what it's about and what it's going to do. And right now, he's predicting that Bitcoin can go over $1.2 million in just the next 5 years. Okay, he said he bought it up at 9,000, and at the time he shot that video, Bitcoin was only 55,000. Of course, it went up above 60,000 before it made its drop, now at about 35,000 or so. And he recently posted on Twitter that if, you know, Bitcoin falls under 30, he's gonna buy a lot more of it. But I think it's a great buying opportunity considering where it will potentially go. So look at it this way. If in 2016, right, you know, Bitcoin was about $400, right? Well, even at its current price, $35,000, you know, $400 5 years ago, I think like times by 9,000%, we'll put it at about $36,000, currently where it's at now. Let's say it does that again and goes 9,000% up in the next 5 years. So while times 9,000%, well, that's like $3.1 million. Okay, so it's not that crazy if you think about it. If Bitcoin hit over 60,000, like if you told me Bitcoin, like in 2016, 5 years ago, would go to 100,000, that would be some crazy speculation, right? But if in 5 years it went from 400 up to 60,000 for its all-time high currently in 2021, telling you now that Bitcoin will go to 100,000 doesn't sound that crazy. In fact, they might do that this year alone when it comes back. So at the rate that, you know, cryptocurrency is moving, and Bitcoin being the king of, you know, crypto right now is holding $1.6 trillion of the market cap. And it actually was at about $2 trillion, and Bitcoin having 40% of dominance, and Ethereum 18% of all crypto dominance. So between Bitcoin and Ethereum alone, they're holding about 60% dominance of the whole cryptocurrency market. Over 10,000 cryptos right now on the market. Is it too late or is it too early to invest in Bitcoin? I think it's an amazing buying opportunity. In fact, I just bought some more Bitcoin at 37,000 or so. If it takes another dip, I'm just gonna buy a little more. Listen, we already hit $60,000 for one Bitcoin, okay? The way it's moving, Bitcoin potentially, you know, based on what we're seeing, it can potentially surpass 100,000, that's six figures, in late 2021. Maybe 2022. And in the next 5 to maybe 8 years or so, we can see Bitcoin rise up to $1 million per Bitcoin. And in the same, you know, time, Ethereum can potentially hit 50,000 to 100,000 per Ethereum. So kind of seeing where it's going, and at the dip where it's at now, about 35,000 or so, do you think it's a great time to maybe start investing into some Bitcoin and Ethereum? I don't know. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm not here to share with you how to, you know, invest your money or spend your money. I'm just sharing with you potentially where cryptocurrency is headed. And I believe we will see a day in the next decade or less that Bitcoin will be at 1 million. Ethereum can potentially be over 100,000. So when I buy Bitcoin at 30,000, and when I still buy Bitcoin at 100,000, it's still going to be a great time to invest considering where it is going, especially if you're holding for the long term. So I believe it can potentially hit these price points. Not a guarantee. We don't know what the future holds, but kind of where it's headed and where it's going and what it's been able to accomplish in the first decade, right, alone, these numbers are really not that far-fetched. So this is why myself, you know, I'm not saying there's a right way and a wrong way to invest in cryptocurrency. I'm just saying that this is how I and my wife, you know, we diversify our cryptocurrency portfolio. From the cryptocurrency that we hold, we like to allocate about 70% into just Bitcoin and Ethereum. They're more stable. They're adaptable regardless of what the market does or how much it falls. They will bounce back because they hold the most dominance. So this is why we hold about 35% in Bitcoin, 35% of our portfolio in Ethereum, and the other 30% we allocate to altcoins and other maybe new cryptos and trading balance for short-term gains. So I just wanted to share that with you. I hope this is helpful and maybe give you a general idea kind of why cryptocurrency, why we hold a big portion of it in our portfolio and why we see a bright future for it. Hey, listen, if this was valuable to you, give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you always get notified when we publish another video. We'd love to share with you the best practices and strategies and ways how you can potentially get positioned in the market and win, regardless what the inflation does or how bad the economy gets. There's always a way to be on the winning side, just like the big whales, just like the wealthy are winning. So the average person right now can win big when you stack up on these wealth assets, kind of understand where it's going, like especially with the cryptocurrency market. If you kind of know where it's going, it's going to help you make smarter moves, right? Not panic sell at the wrong time and not buy at the wrong time, right? Buy the dips, always sell if you need to above your buying price and you will be good. Considering that potentially, let's say the main cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin and Ethereum, knowing that they still have a lot of, most likely growing to do, right? Nobody knows what the future holds for sure, but where it's going and how it's unraveling, we see that it has potentially a bright, bright future. That's why we hold a big stake in cryptocurrency alone. Hey, with that said, I have some good resources for you below as well. So you will also be able to learn how to get positioned with cryptocurrency and how we're actually duplicating it as well, if that's what you want to learn more about. So check out the resources below. They're to help the average person to educate themselves a little more about cryptocurrency, precious metals, and best ways how you can potentially protect yourself against inflation and the big financial storm that's coming, and win big by stacking up on real wealth assets that have a bright future, potentially will appreciate and duplicate your money for you. That's how the wealthy get rich. To your phenomenal success, let me know what you think in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video if you'd like to with anybody else you think it can benefit. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.